Hello and welcome to this course, where I shall be focusing on how some of the AWS storage services can help you with disaster recovery and data backup of your on-premise production resources, resulting in an effective business continuity plan by preventing data loss whilst at the same time reducing your RTO and RPO. Before we start, I'd like to introduce myself. My name is Stuart Scott. I am one of the trainers here at Cloud Academy, and I specialize in AWS, Amazon Web Services. Feel free to connect with me with any questions using the details shown on screen. Alternatively, you can always get in touch with us here at Cloud Academy using a community forum where one of our cloud experts will reply to your question. This course will be of benefit to anyone who is responsible for managing and maintaining AWS storage services, implementing effective data backup solutions from on-premise to AWS, and anyone involved in business continuity management. It would also be an advantage for those looking to take the AWS Solutions Architect Professional Certification. This course will focus on the following topics. Where does cloud storage fit in with disaster recovery? Considerations when planning a DR storage solution? Using Amazon S3 as a data backup solution? Using AWS Snowball for data transfer? Using AWS Storage Gateway for data backup? And then finally, a course summary. By the end of this course, you will have gained an understanding of how your storage solution can affect your business continuity and DR plans. You will also have the knowledge to know when to use specific AWS storage solutions to your advantage between Amazon S3, Amazon Glacier, AWS Snowball, and AWS Storage Gateway, and how each of these can provide a DR solution to fit your specific needs. As a prerequisite to this course, you should have a basic understanding of the following: business continuity, disaster recovery, data backup terms and methodologies, Amazon S3, Amazon EC2, and Elastic Block Storage, EBS. Feedback on our courses here at Cloud Academy are valuable to both us as trainers and any students looking to take the same course in the future. If you have any feedback, positive or negative, it would be greatly appreciated if you could use the comment section found on the landing page of this course. That brings me to the end of this lecture. Coming up next, I'll start off by looking at how cloud storage plays an important part within your DR and business continuity plans.